The universe isn't chaos. It's a machine, a mechanism, a model that was supposed to work. Stars are born, galaxies spin, clusters collide. Everything has its scale, its place, its limits, until you discover something that doesn't fit, something so vast that physics says it has no right to exist, but it exists, a structure larger than anything we've ever seen. We're not talking about a galaxy, not even a cluster of galaxies. We're talking about something bigger than millions of galaxies combined. It's like looking at a map of the universe and suddenly seeing footprints, not yours, not human, not even from this scale. In 2023, scientists discovered a ring made of gamma ray bursts, stretching over 1.3 billion light years. It's as if millions of supernovae were connected into one perfect circle. And now the question, how could something like that form? According to our current cosmology, it couldn't. It's like discovering a mountain bigger than an entire planet, like finding a word in grammar that can't be conjugated, or like the universe revealing that it has bones, seams, a frame. So maybe not everything is chaos. Maybe what we call structure is just a glimpse of something greater, something meant to be hidden or forgotten. And then you start to wonder, is this still physics, or did we just glimpse the outline of someone's hand on the canvas of reality? They called it Laniakea. In Hawaiian, it means immeasurable heaven, but that's not the scientific name. It's a warning, because it's not a galaxy. It's not a cluster of galaxies. It's a gravitational field larger than anything the human mind can grasp. Laniakea connects around 100,000 galaxies into one gigantic structure. Imagine the Milky Way. Multiply it by 100,000. Now try to take it all in with one glance. You can't. It's like trying to see the ocean from the bottom of a well, or trying to understand a city by looking at a single street. And now the twist. We, Earth, the Sun, the entire solar system are inside it, inside this beast. And we're not just drifting there, we're being pulled. Because Laniakea has something else, a point that's sucking us in. Scientists call it the Great Attractor. We can't see it, we don't know what it is. But we know one thing, everything around it is accelerating. It's not just a gravitational point, it's as if space itself is folding there. As if an entire region of the universe is being pulled into something we can't name. So maybe Laniakea isn't a supercluster, maybe it's not just a region of galaxies, maybe it's a movement, a direction, a tunnel. And us, we're not its inhabitants, we're just dust caught in something greater. It started as a joke. Scientists noticed that in one part of the sky, something didn't add up. Gamma ray bursts, the most energetic events in the universe, were forming a strange pattern. But patterns don't matter, right? Space is chaos, randomness, scatter, right? Wrong. Because when they studied it in detail, they found these gamma bursts aligned into something bigger, much bigger, a structure over 10 billion light years long. Not a cluster, not a supercluster, a wall. The Hercules Corona Borealis Great Wall. The name sounds like it's from a strategy game, but this isn't a joke. It's likely the largest observable structure in the universe. And the problem is, it shouldn't exist. Why? Because according to our current cosmological models, the maximum size of structures should be about 1.2 billion light years. Beyond that, the universe should be smooth, like stretched dough. But the Great Wall is 8 times bigger. The universe is a maze, but half of that maze is invisible. And I don't mean metaphorically, I mean literally. Everything you see, galaxies, stars, planets, is only 5% of what actually exists. The rest, it's something invisible, untouchable, non-reflective. And yet, it holds the cosmos together, dark matter. But what is it? It doesn't shine, it doesn't reflect. It doesn't participate in chemical reactions, yet it forms structures larger than entire galaxies. It's like a building made of something that doesn't exist, and yet it stands. And now, the most fascinating part. Maybe these giant structures we're discovering Rings, walls, superclusters aren't random. Maybe they're just shadows, traces of something larger, the unseeable architecture of the cosmos. Or maybe dark matter isn't matter. Maybe it's a law, a code, a leftover from another reality, or a consciousness that doesn't need a body. Now ask yourself, can we really not see it? Or is something preventing us from seeing it? Because if 95% of the universe is invisible, are we living in a grand illusion? And those structures we're discovering, those massive walls, rings, and attractors, are they really part of our universe? Or just outlines of something bigger that's on its way? So either our model of the universe is wrong, something is creating these structures consciously or not, or this isn't our universe anymore. And now, the question that should really worry you, is the Hercules wall a boundary, a wall of our universe? And if so, what's on the other side? Or worse, what happens when we reach it? Has something already been there? Is something waiting? The universe is expanding. Galaxies drift, time moves in one direction, and we, humans, like to think it all makes sense. That something began, and now it's simply unfolding. But maybe not. What if these gigantic structures that shouldn't exist aren't just anomalies, but leftovers from something that came before, before the Big Bang, before time, before us? For years, scientists have debated the idea of cyclic universes, models where our universe isn't the first and not the last, just the next, like a layer of paint on a canvas with other paintings hidden underneath. And maybe these structures, walls, rings, great attractors are fragments of those earlier layers, traces that survived the reset, ashes from the last Big Bang party. Or worse, maybe we're not the only universe, maybe we're just one bubble in a cosmic foam, and these structures, places where two universes touched, collided, left a scar. Now, the weirdest theory, what if none of this is natural? What if someone built it, not with bricks, not with steel, but with gravity, light, and space itself? What if these structures aren't weird anomalies at all, but a message? And here's the question we're afraid to ask, to whom and why? In the beginning, the universe expanded calmly, like a balloon, inflated carefully. But for billions of years, something strange has been happening. Instead of slowing down, it started to speed up. And don't ask why. Physics still throws up its hands. It's not that stars are moving away, it's that the space between them is stretching, as if the universe itself wants to run away from itself. Now imagine this, planets ripped from stars, galaxies disappearing beyond the reach of light. And finally, elementary particles torn apart by the fabric of space itself. This scenario has a name, the Big Rip. The universe won't end in a great implosion. It won't fade out quietly. It will rip itself apart from the inside, and nothing will remain. Not light, not time, not even the idea that something can exist. Maybe that's billions of years away. Maybe not, because we don't know how dark energy behaves. That elusive demon expanding everything. If it shifts, accelerates, the end might come sooner than we think. So the question is, do we understand the universe? Or is it laughing at us? Because if it really will rip apart, why was it created at all? For billions of years, the universe was silent, unnervingly silent. But in recent decades, something began to change. Signals started to appear, regular, rhythmic, like breathing, like a heartbeat. Radio signals, repeating every 16 days. Not randomly, not by chance. Always the same cycle. As if something is breathing, behind the curtain. Galaxies older than they should be. As if they formed before the Big Bang. As if someone started the engine, before shifting gears. Gamma ray bursts, forming perfect rings. Too big, too precise, like a seal, imprinted on space-time. Gas clouds moving faster than light. Yes, that breaks Einstein's rules. And yes, We still don't know how that's possible. But it's happening. Maybe something is activating. Maybe the universe isn't just space. Maybe it's an organism, an algorithm, a machine that's entering a new mode and giving us its first warning. So the question is, are we mere observers or intruders? Because if something is waking up, maybe it just looked back at us. Maybe everything you see isn't a sign of chaos. Maybe those structures that shouldn't exist are there not because the cosmos went crazy, but because we're starting to see more. Maybe we're like a blind person regaining sight. And for the first time, we see the world as it truly is. Vast, strange, alien, not adapted to our senses. Because if 95% of reality is invisible and the largest structures break the laws of physics, then maybe the problem isn't in the cosmos. Maybe the problem is in our perception. Or maybe we're not looking at the universe. Maybe it's looking at us, and only now it's starting to notice us. So the question isn't, what does the universe look like? But this, are we ready to see the truth if what we see isn't us? If this made you see the universe a little differently, thank you for watching. There's so much more waiting beyond the edge of what we know. So if you're curious, if you love questions with no easy answers, subscribe. Let's explore the unknown together.